I'll get started then. So, hello, my name is Christian. Some of you know me. I am going to do this very quick introduction to who I am, and then we'll go over the planned schedule. So, very quickly, just as little salesy as possible, I worked at some of the leading SEO agencies. I've been in this industry for just about 11 or 12 years now. I run my own freelance SEO consultancy, and I've helped tons of websites rank from some of the biggest companies out there that you heard of to some of the smallest. I've been featured on a number of media publications, and generally I consider myself quite good at what I do because clients keep coming back to me and they are satisfied with the results. So how can I actually help you? I provide a number of different services. After today, you decide that you want to go deeper into some of the things mentioned, then I'm very happy to help. So who is this webinar for? You're in the right place if you're a business owner, a marketing manager, you work with websites, or you manage a website that dropped in rankings. And generally, if you do anything to do with websites and you face a website that just doesn't improve in rankings, then this is the right place for you to be. And obviously, I do encourage asking questions, although I did save a bit of time at the end. This webinar will run for about 30 minutes, so I hope you will have some time after that to have your lunch if you're not eating right now. If you are eating right now, bon appetit. I hope it's something tasty. So let's jump straight in. We'll go over the 6 different reasons why websites get stuck, and I will show you a bit of practice here, in practical terms, what I do to actually help websites. And I am recording this webinar. However, this is my first ever webinar of this kind, so I'm not that confident in the recording options here, though I'm using some very recommended software. So you should get a recording at the end of this, so you can go over those things yourself. However, if the recording option doesn't actually happen for whatever reason, I will re-record this webinar in 1 week's time. So you will get a recorded version either way. Right, I think that's all the caveats. Let's jump straight in. The first reason why websites don't rank or stop ranking is the backlink. And within backlinks, the most common issue is the link building that has been done in the past is not good anymore. So what happens is Google changes the rules in an ongoing way. So every week, every month, they change the ways that they rank websites. In the past, someone might have done some building links for you. You may have made some links for your website, submitted it to some directories, gotten some links from some blogs. And sadly enough, over time, Google doesn't consider those websites to be strong anymore or potent or authority. Also, what happens with all those changing rules is sometimes links that were relevant in the past are not relevant anymore. And I'll just show you very quickly. I'm using We Buy Any Car for some of this. I hope they don't mind. They do have a very good backlink profile, but I managed to find one or two links to just show you as an example. I'm going to switch this from the presentation to this screen. And now you should be observing the screen with winch tips from the guys who pull at LeaksCroik, some kind of article about cars here. And I'm looking for the link to We Buy Any Cars within this article right here. And the sentence reads, if you ever try to sell used cars that aren't running anymore, da da da. And the link anchor text is sell used cars. Now, as you can observe, in this article, there is no other link to anywhere in the world. The only link in this article is to rebuy any car with the keyword sell used cars. Now, that's a clearly a way to manipulate search rankings. Someone maybe did it many years ago when this was a recommended technique to link with the keyword that you're trying to rank for. Either way, we can see that there is no relevance. The relevance here is it's kind of the article talks about the cars. They sell cars, so there is a kind of a connection, but the article doesn't actually say anything, nothing about selling cars, buying cars. It's not even relevant to UK in a way, I don't think. It looks like an American website. I hope I don't sound racist saying this. I'm Polish myself, so forgive me if I am. But to me, it looks like an American website. That's what I've seen in the cinema. So anyway, sell used cars, bad link. It looks like manipulated link. Google could say this is a bad link. So over years, maybe 5 years ago, this worked really well. Nowadays, I would say it's not such a good practice anymore. There was one more link here in the article on Lara blog, a general blog talking about all different topics. Again, I wouldn't probably recommend to use this that often. Very old link, as you can see, 2013. So maybe someone from back then. And yes, back then, that was the way. So you can see the link here, sell your car. It links to a different website that it seems to be by any car bot in the time. So anyway, again, a link from more relevant space here. But again, over the years, we wouldn't recommend linking this way. It seems to be manipulated. It seems like this was maybe a purchase link of some kind. So what do we do? I didn't expect that. Is this working? Okay. That's the one. So I switched to the other window. So what do we do with those matching issues? If you're filtering from this side, what I really recommend is generating new links. And the best way to generate them nowadays, it is either to have some people that work for you that can do a lot of legwork in securing your links. It's good to work with a PR agency always. It's good if you have some newsworthy content on your website. It is good if you have some connections here and there to people maybe in the media, maybe people at one other website. Generally, what I do is I review competitor backlinks. So just really quickly to show you one of the tools in action. It's a tool called Majestic SEO. And in this tool, actually that's how I found those backlinks. You just put in the domain of your competitor and you can find their backlinks here. All of them just showed here. And then you can, from looking at these backlinks, you can reverse engineer them and see how did they get this link and can we get it as well. Generally, what I prefer to use here is the trust flow metric within Majestic that shows you how trustworthy a given backlink is. That's generally how I look at those things. Right. So that's much on the backlinks. The reason number two, we mentioned relevancy a little bit. And yes, Google changes the rules on relevancy all the time. There was actually a Google update that came out yesterday, I think. Brand new Google update to talk that talks about content quality and relevancy. Although Google is not admitting anything, but they did mention something to generating great content, as they always say. So the usual issues I see on the content website are either technical duplication or crawling budget issues. So a website that generates way too many pages or has many pages of very low quality. And I'll show you very quickly how I would check it for my own website. And there will be some errors there. I did leave them on purpose. So this is Google Search Console. That's one of the main tools I use every day for all of the clients. This is the backend. I will show you the new version soon. But for now, let's just have a look at this older one that has actually all the functions. There are a few sections here that are particularly important when looking at quality of the content. One of them is, okay, sorry, there's actually no issues at the moment with my website on HTML improvements, but I was trying to leave some. So search appearance, HTML improvements. This is when Google would tell you about duplicate meta descriptions, title tags. They usually indicate more duplication than just that. Another tool to show you here is one called the Siteliner. Now in Siteliner, you can open a website, and it's a free, there is a limit on it to some extent, but Siteliner scans your whole website for duplicate content, and then it will show you it in a graphical way. If you have some time at the end, then I'll show you the result of this. I'm sure there is some of that happening. Where else would we have a look? We would have a look at your analytics as well. So in your analytics, I would look always at landing pages. And on the landing pages, we have such statistics as bounce rate. So I would look at the usual page and usual bounce rate. Well, I'm looking at these pages and they have about 50%. The website average is 55% bounce rate. I would look at pages that have a higher bounce rate than this. Here, everything is pretty static. Obviously, this is my ignore thank you page for the contact form, so I don't mind this bounce rate. The freelance SEO consultancy is 66, e-commerce SEO is 63, and technical SEO are 67. So these are the pages that I would look at improving. Maybe the content relevancy is not quite there. To show you something, the new Google Search Console, and how I found it, I went to Google Search Console, so this address here. I clicked on this button here, try the new Search Console. The new Search Console gives us longer time. We can look at, instead of the last 3 months, we can look at the last 16 or 12 months, for example. That's a very useful thing to know. It allows us to see more data from a given website. What I'm looking at here is, I just click on performance. I'm looking at the keywords that people find me through. And here I can look at the pages. Now, under pages, there are statistics for clicks and impressions. So say I'm looking at this e-commerce page. Yes, that was the one we noticed that wasn't as relevant. Now, that page got 7 clicks only and 9,000 impressions. So there's definitely something wrong here. This means that Google has shown me 9,000 times in the results, but I only got 7 clicks. I'm going to click here and I'm going to see what keywords that people type in to find this page. So I'm click on queries now. E-commerce SEO specialist. Yes, that's the keyword I optimized for. This one is some random one I don't care about, one and one, so nothing. And that's the key here, I think. Demandware SEO. Demandware is actually one of the e-commerce platforms. So I had 2,000 impressions and 0 clicks. I had SEO for Demandware, 900 impressions, 0 clicks. Demandware competitors, okay. Magento e-commerce. So instead of having, now how I would action this data is, this is my current page, e-commerce SEO. Slightly slow internet here in Bali today. Right, so this is my page. I wouldn't say it's very pretty. Obviously, I made it on the older website before I transferred the content to the new website. It doesn't look very good. In the title there, I optimized for e-commerce SEO, specialist Magento, SEO, Demandware, but I don't really mention them on the page at all. Judging from these volumes of queries, I would probably make a new page for Demandware SEO and a new page for Magento SEO e-commerce. That's how I would probably action this. Yes, so you can see some more variations here. It's Demandware Magento SEO Specialist. So I would probably make, yes, Magento e-commerce SEO Specialist would be my name for the Magento page. And how I would make it, I would make a page here called Magento. This is where it would reside. And that's the keyword I would optimize it for. So that's how in literally 5 minutes, I just looked at one page, I discovered why it's not relevant, and how I would edit this page to make it relevant. In this case, I would create more pages. I would generally still upgrade that page because it is not that great looking as you just saw. I am a bit ashamed of my website right now, but there we go. That's how those webinars go, apparently. So what else? There is a... site index query. Yes, I'll show you that really quickly. There is another way of finding out what's going on in the index and any problems with content. You just go to Google and you type in site, then column, and then your website address. And that shows you all the pages, disregarded that website I made 5 pages ago. And that's how you see all the pages from a given website. And occasionally you can see something really weird. Like here I can see an attachment software logo site, which doesn't exist. And then maybe lower down, I can see a category as your basis, so probably don't want this index. I can see another one of the attachment pages. So I'm looking for irregularities here. Any pages that shouldn't be in the index. I shouldn't be indexing my thank you webinar, and I shouldn't be indexing this morning routine URL here on my own website. So straight away, again, 5 minutes looking at a different aspect there, a different way, and I found some more irrelevant things that should be fixed. There is also, I forgot to mention SEMrush. There is a tool also I use, it's a paid tool called SEMrush. I'll send you a link to it after the webinar. There's a special link with my invite. And in that tool, it shows you a number of statistics on your pages. I'll just click it really quickly on Rebuy and a Car here and show you a few statistics. It does some really, really good tracking. There it's very advanced. It shows the, again, it shows you the kind of things I saw in Google Search Console, but a lot more advanced and bigger. It's a great way to spy on your competitors. You can find out what they're optimizing for, what exact keywords they're doing. But it also can show you what keywords your pages are ranking for that are not shown in Google Search Console. So further, it helps with that relevancy. Very, very, very good tool there. But it is paid, obviously. Search Console is free. So, reason three, lack of keyword focus. What happens very often is that people write a lot of blog posts and businesses create a lot of pages on the website, but they never really actually consider what is the overall keyword landscape that they should target and what should that given page be targeting in terms of keywords. As I just showed you in that example in the e-commerce and my page, the e-commerce SEO page, and the other keywords like Magento SEO specialist and Demandware SEO specialist, well, I probably haven't thought it out too well in the past when I was making this page because I should have made all those other pages. Now, the next thing that I often see people don't do when they're trying to get the website moving in rankings is actually tracking performance of the pages they produce. And so how do we actually capture the traffic from Google? We make pages for the website. And although my homepage, obviously my website is just a tiny, tiny website, so it's not the best example here, but all my other clients' data is confidential, so I can show it. Usually, your homepage would be 50% of the traffic, maybe 40, maybe 30, maybe 20 for some. And sub-pages like this page or this page would be generating a lot of supplementary traffic, very good traffic. Now, the more pages like this I have, the more traffic I will get to the website. If I really pushed it hard and I started making more of those pages, soon enough, the homepage would still be driving around 1,000 visits, but all the other pages combined would start getting a lot more. So the idea here is that by generating more pages that are specifically targeted at very good keywords, we can drive a lot more traffic to the website. But if you don't consider those keywords in the first place, if you don't go to Search Console and review the search terms, or we look at SEMrush and we look at competitors' keywords, if you don't actually think about it in the first place, then it's very, very hard to do later on in the campaign and try to rethink it all. And then in the benchmarking, I can show you really quickly how to make a, I would make a very simple, oh, actually, I can't do a lot of confidential stuff. I'll describe it to you roughly how I would do a table like that. You would just look at making a table where you put in the name of the page, the address of the page, and then in the column to the right of it, you just put the number of visits it had in May or in June or in July, and then track that every month. And then track in Google Search Console, it actually does it for you already. If you click on your pages in Google Search Console and compare all the pages, it actually tracks every page month by month. It actually tracks every page month by month, and you can see each page performance. If I click on a single page, I can see what's going on here. This page is not performing great. By making adjustments to those pages, you can improve them as the time goes on. You can see the homepage is actually doing all right recently, the impressions are up again, but the clicks are kind of always the same roughly. But from this, you can see if a page is performing or no. Some of those pages here that I have, you can see they're not getting any clicks at all, so they're not performing really well. Luckily enough, I don't mind because as you can see, the traffic to my homepage is so big that I don't care about those pages. But if I was growing them out, this is how I would measure if they're working or not. If they're actually delivering what they should be delivering for the campaign. So let's have a look at the next issue. Reason number four is the lack of strategy. Again, the very common issue in many companies is they're publishing blog posts, publishing new pages, improving the website, but they actually don't have an overall overarching strategy that says, okay, we will attract Google search organic traffic by having articles to with this particular topic, and we will dominate the questions around the difficulties of our clients in this and this area. So for me, I just have a few keywords, like SEO Freelancer London, Freelancer SEO London. I dominate those keywords, and that's my strategy. However, as you can see, there is so much potential for those e-commerce SEO keywords. I should be looking there as well and improving that and looking in that direction. So for your organization, I would look at, okay, maybe we lost some rankings and some keywords that it's very hard to regain. Where else can we look for other ideas? And then review that every 3 months. And see, are we getting actually more organic traffic? Are we getting more impressions in Google Search Console? Are we realizing the strategy? Or is it just really stuck? Occasionally, you may have to publish, again, as I said, more blog posts, more guides, improve the existing content, add more words to it, optimize your website so it's faster for speed. There are many, many areas to improve. And it's always important to never stop improving it and always keep on tracking it. Many inquiries I get are from clients that don't even know how many visitors they got to their website any given month, or what keywords they actually optimized for in the past. It's a bit like, I don't know if you ever watched Apprentice. Oh, no, it's not Apprentice. It's Shark Tank in the States. And we have the dragons, that's how it's supposed to be. Something with the dragons, it was called. When someone comes with a business idea into the room and they ask them a few questions, like, what's your revenue, what's your turnover, and people don't know their numbers. And then it's like, well, how do you expect us to invest? It's a bit similar here. If you don't even know your organic numbers or your rankings or your keywords, well, how do you expect it all to work? It's a bit like investing in a stock market without knowing anything about any of the stocks. It's important to educate on this and always look at the strategy. So that's a slightly different one, mobile and AMP issues. As you may know, Google is placing more and more focus on... perfect, I had my first question. I had a thank you for the question, and I will answer towards the end. So just trying to get through this because I'm aware I spent a bit too long on the queue on the back thing. So mobile usability issues. I'll show you where to check for this in Search Console. That's where this data resides. So we don't want this new version of Search Console. We want the older version. You have two sections here. One is mobile usability. Again, I don't think I have any issues here. I'm sorry. But under search traffic, mobile usability, that's where issues will show up. Google provides quite good background information on them. And sadly, you will usually have your website designers. You will need your website designers' help because they're highly technical issues. If you're using AMP, accelerated mobile pages that serve content faster on mobile, this is where you would find the issues with them. Google is now using mobile first index for many websites. Somewhere here in the messages to me, just said you may have, if you use Search Console, which I definitely recommend you do, you may have received this message that says here is that mobile first indexing has been enabled for my website, which means Google is using the mobile version of my website for indexing and ranking. And that's really, really important. If your website is not too good on mobile and you lost the rankings, well, that's very likely to be the reason of it. Another common thing, theme I see is people showing some content on desktop, but not showing it on mobile. You want to show all of the content on desktop and on mobile, ensure that it's in both places. This is a slightly technical section, so apologies for that, but that's many, many issues come from this. Analytics versus mobile versus desktop. In your Google Analytics, you can also have a look. It's either behavior or audience. Technology, mobile. Let's have a look. I think it's here. Perfect. So under audience, mobile overview, you can see the statistics that compare the traffic from desktop, mobile, tablet. Don't worry about tablet, it's going away anyway. Was never really bothered about mobile, but you can see the statistics here. The bounce rate on mobile is a lot higher for me. users spend less time, conversions are a lot lower, they're viewing less pages as well. Now, generally, the portion of my traffic is quite low on mobile, so I'm not bothered, but with everyone going on those mobiles and Google using this version, I should improve this. You kind of want your desktop statistics and mobile statistics to be as close as possible. Maybe not obviously in the number of inquiries or the traffic, but in the actual usage of them. So people are visiting the same number of pages or having the same bounce rate. That's something I would be looking for. Again, the improvement frame, it's slightly a topic for a designer, probably for a usability experience guru, to explain how a mobile website should work compared to desktop. You definitely want one version that's responsive. I'll tell you that from a SEO point of view. But how it actually works, what people click, how big the buttons are, I leave that to the designers. All I know is that it should work flawlessly for anyone. Now, the last reason, with those 3 minutes to go that we have, the one that got away, the last reason is the unidentified ranking obstacle, something that no one knows. So as a bonus for the attendance of this webinar, thank you for spending this time with me. I offer a free 30-minute consultation. So if there is an issue with your rankings that I haven't mentioned, something that's stuck there that you tried many SEOs on and no one was able to help you, feel free to email me and I'll be more than happy to help you. Now, the question from the audience was here on... thank you. Hey, Christian, this is awesome. Are you able to share a content calendar with keywords, focus, example templates? I don't have a template to hand, but you know what? I will make one and I will send it to you. So if you just using this Q&A, just drop me an email and ask for it and I'll email it to you and anyone else that would like one. Again, the question was on a content calendar with keyword focus. I should make one. I made tons for my clients. I don't have a template that I use. Actually, most of the stuff I do is always bespoke for a given scenario, for a given website, but I'm more than happy to make a template and share it. That's something I should probably have on my website, right? To improve that relevancy and all those statistics. So thank you so much for attending. Really appreciate your time. I hope you learned something. Again, you have my email, so feel free to ask me any questions. This time is you gave me your 30 minutes, so I will give you back my 30 minutes. Really appreciate it. And yes, thank you so much for your time. Have a great day. And yeah, that's it. Speak to you soon, I hope.